as a point of personal privilege, I'm going to call on Senator Flake to speak. Normally, we would start the vote right now, but as a point of personal privilege, I would call on Senator Flake.
Well, thank you. I've been speaking with a number of people on the other side. We've had conversations ongoing for a while with regard to making sure that we do due diligence here. And I think it would be proper to delay the floor vote for up to, but not more than 1 week, in order to let the FBI continue to do an investigation limited in time and scope to the current allegations that are there, and limited in time to no more than 1 week. And I will vote to advance the bill to the floor with that understanding. And I've spoken to a few other members who on my side of the aisle that may be supportive as well. But that's my position. I think that that we ought to do what we can to make sure that that we do all due diligence with a nomination this important. And I want to say that this committee has acted properly, and the chairman has bent over backwards to do investigations from this committee and to delay this vote in this committee for a week so that Judge, or that that Ms. Ford, Dr. Ford, could be heard, and she was yesterday. So that's, with that agreement, I will vote to advance the bill to the floor.
Clerk will call the roll.
Just 1 second. Can Diane speak?
Could we have a description?
What are we voting on? Let's see.
We are voting on the motion to report the nomination to the floor. The clerk will call the roll.
Wait, that's not my understanding of what, Mr. Chairman. Let the senator explain it.
That is my understanding, and if the Democrats could speak to it, if Chris or you, as we talked about before, that the Democrats would accept and endorse a 1 week FBI investigation limited in time and scope.
Well, that is correct. Since you're the deciding vote here, we'll vote, and then if there's any sort of discussion, we'll go do that after the vote. Call the roll.
Mr. Hatch.
Aye.
Mr. Graham.
Aye.
Mr. Cornyn.
Aye.
Mr. Lee.
Aye.
Aye.
Mr.
Flake.
Aye.
Mr. Tillis.
Aye.
Mr. Kennedy.
This is
aye.
On the nominee.
Mrs. Feinstein.
Yeah.
On the nominee, no.
Mr. Leahy.
On the nominee, no.
Mr. Durbin.
No.
Mr. Whitehouse.
No.
Ms. Klobuchar.
No.
Mr. Coon.
On the nominee, no.
Mr. Blumenthal.
No.
Ms. Hirono.
No.
Mr. Booker.
No.
Ms. Harris.
No.
Mr. Chairman.
Aye.
Mr. Chairman, the votes are 11 days, 10 days.
The nominee will be reported to the floor.
Mr. Chairman, may I be recognized?
Yes.
Thank you, Mr. Chairman. I just want to thank my friend and colleague, Senator Flake, and thank you for giving us the time today to have a conversation. A number of my colleagues have asked for a one-week delay in order that there might be an FBI investigation of what allegations are currently before this committee. I respect Senator Flake's view that, in his opinion, it was best to respect your having given Dr. Ford the time to be heard yesterday and advance the nominee to the floor. But it is my hope that we could work together on a bipartisan basis to diligently pursue an FBI investigation within the next week, not for the purpose of delay, but for the purpose of investigating further either allegations made by Dr. Ford or others, with a goal towards demonstrating a bipartisan commitment to diligently investigating these allegations. Thank you, Mr. Chairman. Thank you, Senator Flake.
Senator Feinstein.
Thank you. I would support that motion. I think we do need this investigation. As a matter of fact, I sort of misunderstood, Senator Flake, what you were doing. I thought it included a one-week investigation. So I would like to support the motion for that investigation.
Ms. Chairman.
Mr. Chairman.
We'll take turns here. Senator.
I love this committee, but we're not the majority leader. Senator Flake has made clear what it would take him to be comfortable on a final passage vote. But it doesn't matter what we say here. This will be up to Senator Schumer and Senator McConnell, so.
It is completely up to them.
Yeah, and I think Jeff has made himself very clear, and
Senator,
let's move.
Senator Leahy. Senator Leahy.
Well, Mr. Chairman, I want to make sure, because this is somewhat unprecedented. When I do agree with the senator from Arizona that we should have this further investigation. So my understanding is that during the week that that is taking place, there will be no action on the floor of the United States Senate on this nomination. Is that correct?
I cannot say that.
Let me say again, I can't make that commitment for the leadership. I can only say that I would be only comfortable moving forward on the floor. I'll move it out of committee, but I will only be comfortable moving on the floor until the FBI has done more investigation than they have already. It may not take them a week. I understand that some of these witnesses may not want to discuss anything further. But I think we owe them due diligence.
Mr. Chairman.
Just a minute. All I have said to Senator Flake is that I would advocate for the position he took, but I don't control that. Senator?
Mr. Chairman.
Yes. Senator Klobuchar.
Mr. Chairman, there are other senators as well who may be interested in this negotiation on the Republican side. And there's not really a set agreement here. All of us had already said we were voting no. It is simply Senator Flake working with all of us to say, for the good of the Senate and the good of the court, the American people deserve to have the facts followed up on. And I really appreciate his willingness to do that. And that is what this is about. This is simply about, and by the way, if Senator McConnell wants to go forward in light of that, and we still have several senators that haven't said how they're voting on this nominee, I actually think this is very important, what just happened right now. So Senator, it doesn't have to have an agreement. It is one senator who's standing up.
Senator Cornyn.
Mr. Chairman, I just want to express my appreciation to Senator Flake for allowing this process to move forward. There's some difference of opinion among us as to what exactly the FBI investigation would consist of. Some of us think it has been concluded and supplemented by this committee's investigation. Others disagree with that. But I respect the fact that not only Senator Flake advocated to give Dr. Ford a chance to appear in front of the committee, which was the right thing to do, but also that he's allowed this process to move forward, subject to further discussions about what the FBI may or may not be able to come up with, but certainly he maintains his right to cast his vote yay or nay as he sees fit and maintains significant leverage that way. But I appreciate his support for a full and fair hearing for Dr. Ford and Judge Kavanaugh, as well as his willingness to allow this to go forward subject to his request.
Mr. Chairman.
Mr. Chairman.
Senator Blumenthal, I think I ought to Senator Feinstein. And then,
if I, through the chair, could ask a question of Senator Flake, does your amendment include continuing the investigation during this period of time?
If I can respond, there is no amendment. I'm simply stating, and the discussion that we had between us all is that I would hope, and I think we had some agreement before, that the Democrats who have been, I think, justifiably uncomfortable moving ahead, could publicly, in an effort to bring this country together, say that we would feel better. I'm not expecting them to vote yes, but not to complain that an FBI investigation has not occurred. This is what I'm trying to do. This country's being ripped apart here, and we've got to make sure that we do due diligence. I think this committee has done a good job, but I do think that we can have a short pause and make sure that the FBI can investigate. My understanding is that some of us would have to, and I'm prepared to do it, make a request to the White House to ask the FBI to do that investigation. It would be short and limited in scope to the current allegations that have been made.
Mr. Chairman.
But I would just encourage the Democrats who we talked to before to endorse that kind of thing, that we can then move on.
Mr. Chairman.
Because of the two-hour rule, we're adjourned.
What?
The two-hour rule.
No vote.
When did we come in? Did we come in at noon?
No. Yeah, we did. Yeah, the two-hour rule.
We came in at noon?
Yeah, we knew you we had to get this all done by 2 o'clock.
Well, is it done? Is Flake's is it going to happen, or did you cut off a vote?
No, we didn't have a motion in front of us. This is all a gentleman and women's agreement.
But I would assume
gentlemen and women's agreement.
I would assume,
but I'm committed to.
Chuck. Let him say what he's committed to.
Well.
Hey, John.
They've turned off the microphones over there, but you could hear Senator Feinstein complaining that all of a sudden Chuck Grassley announces there's a two-hour rule. It was 2 hours, and so he abruptly ends it after the Senate Judiciary Committee passed the confirmation of Judge Kavanaugh along strict party lines, 11 to 10. Jeff Flake, there you see him in the middle of your screen speaking with Senator Coons. Jeff Flake saying he hopes now, at least before there's a final vote on the Senate floor, there's up to a one-week investigation by the FBI of these allegations against Judge Kavanaugh. He says it would be limited in time, limited in scope, involving the current allegations. Dana, explain. It's a little complicated right now, but explain.
Let's just move past this two-hour rule thing, which is an arcane issue, but it's the reason they just all abruptly, very oddly, got up. And let's talk about the most important issue at hand, which is this vote and this investigation. So what just happened is incredibly dramatic and incredibly important in that this Republican, Jeff Flake, after getting accosted in a really dramatic, emotional, obviously sincere way from a couple of women in the hallways, caught on camera, was live on CNN. Mm-hmm. Combine that with him listening to his colleagues in the Senate this morning, including and especially Chris Coons of Delaware, making an impassioned argument to delay this, to do a real investigation. Flake and Coons went off, they had a conversation, and what he agreed on, this is only his personal preference, is to delay the Senate floor vote for a week while an FBI investigation goes on. So that is his preference. He holds a lot of power because there's a razor-thin majority, and his vote is going to be incredibly important. But here are the two realities that have not yet been dealt with. Number one, he doesn't control the floor of the U.S. Senate. Mitch McConnell, his leader, the Republican majority leader, does, and he made that clear. So it's going to be a question of whether McConnell is going to be okay with this. His decision on whether being okay, he meaning McConnell, is simple math, because if it's not just Flake, and if he has Susan Collins and or Lisa Murkowski, frankly, he just needs one other senator to agree with him on this, McConnell won't have a choice because he won't have the votes to confirm Brett Kavanaugh. So that's number one.
Unless Joe Manchin a Democrat decides
but it is true, but it's very hard to see given what Jeff Flake just did. And then the second important thing is the FBI. It is the White House, the president, that has to okay an FBI investigation. They have said flat out, no, we're not going to do that for the last week plus.
They won't get their nominee.
But the pressure, again, just like it is on Mitch McConnell, is on the president to do this, to say, okay, we're going to do this FBI investigation, which is going to have a limited time, limited scope for 1 week, according to what they just agreed to, a general men and women's agreement. And so those are the two outstanding factors right now about whether this week-long delay is actually going to happen. Mitch McConnell and the president of the United States.
And you know how the president feels about the FBI, deep state, all the rest of it. So the president's going to get this request, and maybe he'll call Chris Wray and say, you know, do you promise me this is going to be not biased, and do you promise me that this is going to be
Senator
sure?
Senator Leahy was speaking. Well, he's walking away right now. But go ahead, Dana, finish with it. Senator Klobuchar.
Flake have been working together on this for quite a while, and a number of us have been urging them along. But this was kind of a surprise to all of us. Senator Flake has expressed, including in his speech yesterday, his concern about the divide in this country that is being exacerbated by what's happening here. And, of course, we have been asking over and over again for follow-ups on the evidence. And so Senator Flake is basically saying, to his leadership, I want to see this additional investigation before I vote for this nominee. And if he is joined by one or two other Republicans in that request, then they wouldn't have the votes unless the investigation occurred. You know, and it's that simple. I don't know. You'll have to ask them. It is 1 week, given 1 week is what Senator Flake was interested in, and you can do a lot if you have the whole FBI looking at things in 1 week.
Did Senator Flake bring this idea to the Democrats? Did the Democrats reject it?
You should talk to Senator Flake about that. But I think you've seen him to be quite an independent in terms of a lot of the decisions he makes and what he says, and he just felt that he had a very important role to play here as a member of the committee. Thank you.
Is he still in there? Is he still in there?
I believe he's still in there. And again, a number of us had suggested the week. I suggested it today, as did Senator Coons. And did we actually think that this was going to happen today? No. But we are in a better place than we were at 8 a.m. this morning.
Why do you think the flake switched?
I think you should talk to him.
What did you?
All right, so that's Senator Amy Klobuchar. Quickly, want to go to Manu Raju, who's up there on Capitol Hill. So, Manu, what happens now?
Well, the question ultimately is how this will unfold. What Jeff Flake said, importantly, in that
hold on, Manu. Hold on, Manu. Let's listen to Lindsey Graham.
I hope some Democrats will say if we do what Jeff said, that would end the process dispute, at least a few of them. I don't expect any of them to vote for the guy, but if we ask the FBI to look at what's in front of us no later than a week, no longer than a week, and they would say that would be a better process, that would be progress, and Jeff's trying his best to, you know, bring the country together and vote the best way he knows how. So I don't know if that's the agreement. I'll get back with you.
And do you expect Senator McConnell to honor this?
I don't
agreement?
Know. That's why I'm going to go talk to him right now.
Do you think it would be a good idea if he did honor this?
Last time I looked, you need 50 votes.
So, but right now we don't know if anybody else would join up.
Well, all I can say is that right now, what Jeff is saying is in the is makes
but
sense to me.
So do you think that Murkowski comes?
I don't know. I'm not speaking for Mitch. I'm going to talk with Jeff. And somebody's got to explain this to Trump. So I guess that'll be my job.
If it's going to take this to get those 50 votes, are you going to back this move?
Huh?
If it's going to take this
if
move
I'm
to
nothing,
get 50
I'm
votes?
Practical. Okay.
Thank you, Senator. George,
all right, so there's Lindsey Graham. Manu, I interrupted you, but you were telling our viewers what happens now.
Well, it's unclear. I mean, that's the bottom line. Talking to Republicans who are leaving this meeting, they were surprised by this 11th-hour request, and they themselves are uncertain. John Cornyn just talked to reporters as he was leaving, and he said it's unclear because in 1 week's time, how much clarity can the FBI actually give on this incident from more than three decades ago? Also, the White House presumably would have to call on the FBI to reopen that investigation or to initiate this investigation. So there are some steps in the process that have to happen. Now, if Mitch McConnell were to ignore Jeff Flake's request and still push ahead to begin the process this weekend and push for a confirmation vote next week, he probably would not have the votes to do that if Jeff Flake were to withhold his support and if Elisa Murkowski or Susan Collins also were to withhold his vote. And here's Lindsey Graham right now talking to reporters.
Explain it because I don't know what it is.
Well, so
do you support this 1 week? Do you support this 1 week?
Here's, I'm trying to find out what is. So I just talked to Jeff. I'm going to meet with him and Senator McConnell. Jeff believes, and on the process side, the committee has been very fair and that we've been over backwards. I think he's been upset about the committee being information being withheld and some of the games being played. But he believes if the FBI had a few more days, some Democrats have told him that would alleviate their process concerns, even though they're not going to vote for him. So I think what Jeff is trying to do is end this the best he possibly can to accommodate some people on the other side and to, you know, bring the committee to together if possible. So this is democracy. Am I mad at Jeff? No. Am I in a different place? Yes.
But what happens if the FBI is not done with this background check or investigation within a week?
Jeff is saying, well, one, you can have the FBI, the CIA, and the Foreign Legion, and they're not going to tell you any more than you know now. That's my view, but we'll see what happens.
If they're not done, then what's going to happen? Senator.
He said he's going to... A week is enough for him, or maybe less. So we're not playing this game of opening this up and it goes on forever. What he said was that I would feel better if they had a week to look at what's in front of us, no more. Some Democrats have said okay with that. Now, I'd like them to come forward. I'm going to talk to Mitch and Jeff and eventually engage with the White House. But, you know, again, I don't think we need this. I am long since ready to vote. I think he's been very... poorly treated Judge Kavanaugh.
Has the Republican leadership agreed to this? Has the Republican leadership...
Judge Kavanaugh's nomination? Huh? Do you think this is going to sink Judge Kavanaugh's nomination?
Oh, absolutely not. I think Jeff feels good about Judge Kavanaugh. He just want to make sure the process is fair. But you need to ask him. I've never felt better about him being on the bench than I do right now.
Has Senator McConnell agreed to this?
Senator Murkowski was going to vote yes. So what changed?
This is called democracy. He talked to his colleagues, and they're going, Jeff, please, please just give us a few more days. And Jeff's a really good guy. I wouldn't have done it. but please, let's be fair. And Jeff is trying to be fair. I just don't see we're going to benefit from anything in terms of been doing this most of my adult life. It's 35 years ago. You know what you know, and you've heard what you're going to hear. But having said that, this is called democracy.
Has Senator McConnell agreed to this?
Like you who believe that Brett Kavanaugh is innocent of these things he's been accused of, do you think this might help other people in the country feel better about this person on the Supreme Court if a week from now the FBI comes back and says, we're good?
I think the people in the country are going to feel differently a week from now. You could probably put in a phone booth. However, if... Jeff feels better about it. I feel better about it.
I'm a practical guy.
Just a process. Senator Graham, do you think
have you spoken to Senator?
He was confronted by protesters on his way to vote this morning.
No, no. Listen, this is Jeff Flake. I mean, this is what I actually like about the guy, Susan. I mean, all these people take it really seriously. Jeff is not a lawyer. This is hard. You know, again, I've been in the legal system. You have a lot of emotional decisions to make, but the fact pattern here leads itself to, you know, I'm sorry, there's just not enough. We've got to move on. But having said that, this is Jeff Flake being very sincere. And what he's trying to do, I respect the hell out of this, trying to get some Democrats to buy in. Will a week matter? And some of them said it would. Some of them want to just go on and on and on. But if you can get a few of them to say a week longer would make it a better process, then he's probably done.
Do you think the Republican leadership has agreed to a one-week delay?
Well, if I could quit talking to y'all, I'll go find out.
You heard of that?